Long run average cost curve Part 8. In this lesson, we shall try to compare the short run average cost curve with long run average cost curve. Both the curves are U-shaped. Similarity ends here. Now the differences. 1. The short run average cost curve has two components. They are average fixed cost and average variable cost. The vertical addition of average fixed cost curve and average variable cost curve gives the short run average cost curve. Long run average cost curve consists of only one component. It is average variable cost. In the long run, all costs are variable. Hence, long run average cost is formed by the cost incurred on the variable factors. 2. The U-shape of the short run average cost curve is pronounced at the bottom. The bottom of the long run average cost curve is relatively flat. 3. The shape of the short run average cost curve is governed by the law of variable proportions. It falls initially because of the operation of the law of increasing returns. At the minimum point, law of constant returns operates. Beyond that, law of decreasing returns makes the short run average cost curve to slope upwards. The laws of returns to scale defined the shape of the long run average cost curve. The operation of the law of increasing returns to scale makes the curve to fall first. The long run average cost curve rises due to the law of decreasing returns to scale. At its minimum point, the law of constant returns to scale operates. 4. The short run average cost curve is a plant curve. In the short run, a firm is tied to a given plant size. It has to use that plant. It has to move along the short run average cost curve. It means only by varying the variable cost, the firm produces different levels of output. The long run average cost curve is a planning curve. The firm moves along the long run average cost curve. It means it can move from one plant size to another plant size to produce a given level of output. 5. When a firm operates at the minimum point of the plant curve, it utilizes its full capacity. When a firm operates at the minimum point of the long run average cost curve, the firm becomes optimum. It utilizes the full capacity of the plant. The output is optimum because it is produced at the least cost.